Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how the KeyListener interface works in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay everybody, let's get started. Now within my project folder I have two classes, one class called main, and it contains an instance of my other class called MyFrame. MyFrame extends JFrame, so it behaves exactly like a JFrame, and within the constructor for MyFrame, for this class, I have four lines of code, this.setDefaultCloseOperation, JFrame exit on close, I'm using a size of 500 by 500, this next part's important, I'm using no layout manager, this.setLayout is set to null, because we're going to be manually moving components within the frame by using some keystrokes, and lastly, this.setVisible is set to true. One of a few ways in which you can use a KeyListener interface is just to add that after the class definition. MyFrame extends JFrame, implements the KeyListener interface. And with interfaces, you need to add any unimplemented methods. And for KeyListeners, there's currently three: keyTyped, keyPressed, and keyReleased. And in just a moment, I'll explain the difference between the three. But we need to add a KeyListener to this frame. So we can type in the name of the frame, which is just this, add key listener. And since we're implementing a key listener interface, we can simply just pass in this. So this frame will now respond to key events. And we have key typed, key pressed, and key released. And let me explain the difference between these three. I've added just a few short descriptions underneath each of these methods. Let's begin with key typed. Key typed is invoked when a key is typed. This uses a key char or key character. It gives us a character output depending on the key that is pressed. Key pressed is invoked when a physical key is pressed down. This uses a key code. It gives us an integer number depending on the number of the button that is pressed down. Each button on your keyboard has an associated number, and key code gives us the number of the button. And key released is fairly simple. It's called whenever a button is released. So let's actually display what the difference between a key char and a key code is. So within our keyReleased method, this is going to be called whenever we release a button. So let's actually display some key characters as well as some key codes. So let's begin with some key characters. So let's add a print line that says, you released key character, and we can get the key character of this event by typing e.getKeyChar. And let's try this. So I'm going to press Q, and it says your released key character Q, W-E-R-T-Y, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you can actually use capital letters, so I'm going to hold down Shift and type in Q-W-E-R-T-Y. So those are key characters. Now key code is the number of the button. You released key code, and this is e.getKeyCode. So each of these buttons has a number. Actually, let me turn this line into a comment for now. So I'm going to type in Q, and the number of the button, of the Q button, is 81. W is 87, E is 69, R is 82, T is 84, and Y is 89. So lowercase q is 81. But uppercase Q is also 81 because I'm holding down the same button. And 16 is Shift, and I just released it, so that's why this was triggered. So let's actually display these together now. So Q, the button that contains the Q symbol, produces a character, a key character of Q, and the button number, the key code, is 81. Now if I were to hold down Shift and then press the same button, this is producing a different key character, capital Q, but the key code is still the same, because it's still the same button. So that's the difference between a key character and a key code. And then I'm still holding down Shift. If I were to release it, it's going to give us the key character and the key code. Well, Shift doesn't produce any key characters, that's why it's confused, but it has a certain key code of 16. And what we're going to be doing in this video is creating a simple label, and we'll move the label around the frame by using either key typed or key pressed. So let's declare a label and then define it. So JLabel, and let's call this label. And within the constructor, let's instantiate this label. Label equals new JLabel. And let's set the bounds for this label. Label.setBounds. We're setting the bounds since we're using no layout manager. Let's say we want this to start in the top left corner of the frame. That is where X is 0, Y is 0. Let's make the width 100 and the height 100. And let's set a background color. Label.setBackground. Why not red, I guess. And in order to display the background color, we need to label.setOpaque and set this to true, because the background color doesn't like to display if you don't set the opacity, set opaque to true. All right, and then we need to add this label to the frame, this.add, and we're adding our label. And we should have a simple label in the top left corner. Now, this is our label. We're going to move this label around the frame depending on the key that we press or the key that we type. Let's begin by filling in the keyTyped method. We can evaluate the key character that is being produced, and this would be best by using a switch. You could write this with a bunch of if statements, but it's not as efficient. So let's use a switch. And what we're going to be passing into the switch to examine is e.getKeyCharacter. This will produce a character, and then we can use the switch to determine what character is being used. So let's set different cases. Let's have a case for A to move to the left, W to move up, S to move down, and D to move right. So if the key character that is being produced is A, if somebody types in the character A, we want to move our label to the left. And one way in which we can do that is by using the name of our label, label.setLocation, and we pass in some coordinates, some new coordinates of where we want to place this label. On the y-axis, we want to keep this the same, so we can use label.getY. And we're going to do the same thing for x, but we're going to adjust it slightly. Label.getX. But if we want to move to the left, we want to subtract a number from this. Let's say just one pixel, we'll keep this small. And let's try this. So we have our label. If I were to press A, this is slowly moving to the left. But we need to set this for the other directions as well. So I'm going to add a break after this case, and I'm just going to indent this slightly, just so it's easier to read. So let's have a case for W, S, and D. So case W, we want X to stay the same, but we want to move up. So we subtract a number from Y. And then we need S and D. S will move down, so this is plus 1. And then X stays the same. And lastly, D. X will just add 1. And Y, we will keep the same. And now we should be able to move up, down, left, and right. Down, right, up, left. So this is moving fairly slow. We can actually increase the amount of pixels this is moving after each key character. So let's change this from 1 to 10. And this is going to be more drastic. All right, this is moving much faster now. But yeah, you get the idea. Now let's do the same thing, but use the arrow keys on the keyboard. The arrow keys do not produce a key character, but you can use key pressed for these. So let's actually copy this switch that we have and paste it within here. And this time we're going to be using the key code. So let's pass in the key code underneath key pressed. And the case will be, actually, we need to see what these buttons are first. Okay, so left is 37, up is 38, down is 40, and right is 39. So we're going to pass in or use these numbers for the cases. So let's begin with left. That is 37. 37, we're going to be moving to the left minus 10 pixels. Case 38, we're going to be moving up by 10 pixels, by 10. 39 is down. Actually, that's right. So we're going to move to the right by 10. And then 40 should be down. And this is, X is going to be the same, and Y is plus 10. All right, I'm not going to use WASD. I'm using the arrow keys on my keyboard. So down, right, up, and then left. Now, I have a special treat to show you guys before you go. Instead of moving our boring red label on the screen, let's move an image. I have an image of a rocket that I want to use in place of this red square. So I'm going to add this icon to the label, but first we need to create an icon. So if you want, feel free to pause the video and download an image that you want to use. So I'm going to create an image icon. We'll call this icon. First, let's declare it, and then within the constructor, we'll instantiate it. Icon equals new image icon, and then I'm going to list either the file path or the file location. Since this is within my project folder, I can just list the file name, and that is rocket.png. And I am not going to use the background color, and I am not going to set this to opaque. I'm going to add this icon to the label, label.setIcon, and then I'm going to pass in my icon that I want to use. And now I have a rocket ship on here. And I'm going to change the background color because why not? So to change the background color of the frame, that is this.getContentPane.setBackground. And we'll just pass in color.black to represent outer space. And now we have the very beginning of a simple game. So maybe you could do like Invaders or something where you can move your character left and right and dodge bullets or something. But yeah, I just wanted to show you guys that before you go. So that's the basics of the KeyListener interface. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the KeyListener interface in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.